With focus on social inclusion and economic welfare of the people, health and education for all continues to remain a priority in this year's budget. Finance Minister has proposed an allocation of 37,330 crore rupees to the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, which is an increase of almost 80% over last year. The sector in 2012-13 was provided 20,542 crore rupees.
Health for all and education for all remain our priorities. I propose to allocate rupees 37,330 crore to the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Of this, the new National Health Mission that combines the rural mission and the proposed urban mission will get rupees 21,239 crore, an increase of 24.3% over the RE.
Much emphasis has been given on medical education, training and research for better health of the nation, and funds to the tune of 4,727 crore rupees have been allocated for the same. In order to mainstream Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha and Homeopathy, Department of Ayush has been allocated 1,069 crore rupees.
The six AIIMS-like institutions have admitted their first batch of students in the academic session that commenced in September 2012. I propose to provide rupees 4,727 crore for medical education, training and research.
Education being another key sector for overall development, this sector has also seen an increase in its allocation. The Ministry of Human Resource Development has been provided with 65,867 crore rupees for 2013-14. In order to provide education to all, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan and Right to Education Act are firmly in place. Scholarship will also be given to students belonging to weaker section of the society, minorities and girl education.
The thousands of scholarships will be given to students belonging to scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, other backward classes and minorities and girl children in 2013-14. I propose to allocate rupees 5,284 crore to the various ministries for the purpose.
Skill development is another area of emphasis. An ambitious target has been set for providing skill to 50 million people in the 12th plan period. Other than this, the flagship direct benefit transfer scheme has also captured the imagination of the people, especially the poor. The scheme that was rolled out on 1st January 2013 in select districts will be rolled out throughout the country during the term of the UPA government. So far, nearly 11 lakh beneficiaries have received the benefit directly into their bank accounts. While the hike in budgetary allocation for social sector is a positive push, the better management of funds and implementation of the same on ground will remain a challenge. Business Desk, DD News.